Hello children, today's thought. All of us do not have equal talent, but all of us have an equal opportunity to develop our talents. All of us do not have equal talent, but all of us have an equal opportunity to develop our talents. Now, let us continue with our second chapter of Maths 2, that is parallel lines. Students, in previous videos you have studied about interior angles theorem, corresponding angles theorem, alternate angles theorem, interior angles test, corresponding angles test, alternate angles test, and the sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Now, what is interior angles theorem? If two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, the interior angles on either side of the transversal are supplementary. This is your interior angle theorem. Now, interior angles test. If the interior angles formed by a transversal of two distinct lines are supplementary, then the two lines are parallel. The simple meaning means, interior angles theorem means, if two lines are parallel, then interior angles are supplementary. And interior angles test means, if interior angles are supplementary, then two lines are parallel. Next is corresponding angles theorem. The corresponding angles formed by a transversal of two parallel lines are of equal measure. This is your corresponding angles theorem. And corresponding angles test is, if a pair of corresponding angles formed by a transversal of two lines is congruent, then the two lines are parallel. In simple words, corresponding angles theorem means, if two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are congruent. And corresponding angles test means, if corresponding angles are congruent, then lines are parallel. Next is alternate angles theorem. The alternate angles formed by a transversal of two parallel lines are of equal measure. Okay, this is alternate angles theorem and alternate angles test. If a pair of alternate angles formed by a transversal of two lines is congruent, then the two lines are parallel. Again, in simple words, alternate angles theorem means, if two lines are parallel, then alternate angles are congruent. And alternate angles test means, if alternate angles are congruent, then two lines are parallel. Students, in your book, page number 20, in corresponding angles test, in proof part, corresponding angles test, proof part, one statement is given. And that statement is, that is, a pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is congruent. This statement is wrong. That is, a pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is congruent. This statement is wrong. So, instead of this statement, write, angle B and angle C are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Write this statement. But angle B and angle C are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Students, make this correction in your textbook also and in your notebook also. Now we will solve questions from practice set 2.2. First question. In figure 2.18, y equal to 108 degree and x equal to 71 degree. Are the lines M and N parallel? Justify. Two lines are given, line M and line N. L is the transversal. This angle is X and this angle is Y. So, measure of angle X is 71 degree. X equal to 71 degree and Y equal to 108 degree. Y equal to 108 degree. So, are the lines MN and parallel? Justify. Proof. Angle Y equal to 108 degree. It is given. Y equal to 108 degree. This is your equation 1. Angle X equal to 71 degree. Again, angle X equal to 71 degrees also given. This is your equation 2. So, angle Y equal to 108 degree is equation 1. Angle X equal to 71 degrees is your equation 2. Adding 1 and 2. Adding 1 and 2. So, angle X plus angle Y. Angle X plus angle Y equal to 71 degree plus 108 degree. 71 degree plus 108 degree. Therefore, angle X plus angle Y equal to 179 degree. 71 plus 108 is 179. Therefore, angle X plus angle Y equal to 179 degree. Angle X and angle Y forms a pair of interior angles. Angle X and angle Y forms a pair of interior angles. Since they are not supplementary, therefore line M is not parallel to line N. Therefore, line M is not parallel to line N. Now, question number 2. In the given figure, if angle A is congruent to angle B, then prove that line L is parallel to line M. In the given figure, if angle A is congruent to angle B, then prove that line L is parallel to line M. Again, two lines are given, line L and line M, and N is the transversal. This is angle A and this is angle B, and it is given angle A is congruent to angle B. Angle A is congruent to angle B. It is given. Now, proof. Consider C as shown in the figure. Take this angle C. So, consider C as shown in the figure. Angle A equal to angle B. It is given. Angle A congruent to angle B. It is given. This is your equation 1. Angle A is equal to angle C, vertically opposite angles. Angle A equal to angle C, vertically opposite angles. This is your equation 2. So, angle A equal to angle B is your equation 1. Angle A equal to angle C is your equation 2. Therefore, angle B is equal to angle C. B is equal to angle C from 1 and 2. Therefore, angle B is equal to angle C from 1 and 2. Students, but B and C are which type of angles? B and C are, they are corresponding angles. And if corresponding angles are congruent, then lines are parallel. So, angle B is equal to angle C from 1 and 2. Therefore, line L is parallel to line M by corresponding angles test. Corresponding angles are congruent, that's why lines are parallel. So, by corresponding angles test.